Hi, I'm Pablo Dovaro. I'm the developer of Sculpt Mode, the sculpting and painting tools in Blender. And today I'm going to talk about the new features that are being developed for Sculpt Mode. So first, the introduction. As I said, I'm Pablo Dovaro, and I'm the for you probably know me as the other Pablo, the Pablo that codes the new sculpting features that you may know from Blender today. So I'm this guy, just for clarifications. Okay, so as you may notice, like in 2.92 and in the latest like Blender Today updates, there's like less sculpting related features than usual. That's because the development workflow for Sculpt Mode and my development workflow changed like at the end of 2.91, I think. So before that, the new features that I developed, like the cloth brush and cloth sculpting and the filters and pose and all those things, were developed directly in Master. And like, because these features are kind of, we could say, experimental. It's like you don't really know how the feature is going to work in all workflow cases. It's like that was adding like a lot of overhead to the development. It's like if you have to pass every single tweak and every single change through review and document everything when you are like completely sure that that is going to be the final design. You just have like abstract ideas that you can start coding, but that was done that way so you can like have the features faster in every release. But since 2.91 that changed, so now I'm developing the features in a separate branch, which I'm using, and I'm constantly using that branch to like create artworks and like properly test everything. So the new features that are going to come is like they are not coming like in the MVP state, like in this is the minimum version that can be shipped as a features. Like from now on, it's like the features are final. It's like this is the thing. The thing you are going to see today is like this is exactly how I designed it. It's like it's probably the first Blender feature that landed in Master in a state that's like this is can be considered final. So yes, like this obviously was a huge patch that Jax Luke reviewed, so thank you. But yeah, it's like so first I'm going to clarify that this is not a tutorial, this is more like for explaining you the kind of things that you are going to be able to do with this new feature. Because again, it's something that's not something that is new, is something that doesn't. There's not a similar workflow that you can like reference anywhere else, as far as I know. So this is also like really early stage development software. So a lot of things can change, shortcuts can change, the UI can change, and it's going to crash probably a lot of times because this is not the final product. It's like this is a development build. That's not even alpha. It's like it's my development build. So yeah, it's like having clarified that, I'm going like to explain you where everything comes. It's like this is 2.92, and you may know that since 2.81, since the first version I started working for Blender, there was an operator that was called mask expand, which was in the shortcut Shift A. And it does this. It just like expands an inverted mask from a vertex, and when you click, it blurs the mask. And that's the only thing it does. And in 2.83, when I introduced the facets, I added a separate mode to that operator that does the exact same thing, but with a facet in Shift W. And this was pretty much it. So when I designed this, it's like my idea was, okay, this is because I'm doing this like with this queer nonsense of pentagon of square shape because of a technical limitation that's like, there's currently no way around that. It's like, that code in Blender is missing, we can't have anything better. So I rather wait for having the proper algorithm to be able to code the feature like exactly as I want it to be. So one day, I think last month, Brecht committed this first patch to 2.93, which apparently is like a minor feature, but it's like, this thing is huge. It's like the implications this patch have are huge. And one of those things is like, especially for scale mode, the kind of tools that this is going to allow are incredible. So yeah, it's like, thanks Brecht for working on this. It's like, so you have like a better understanding of what that patch does. It's like in 2.92, if you take proportional editing connected only and you move, see these weird artifacts. This is similar cause of why mask expand in 2.92 was doing the square shape. But now in 2.93, if you go to proportional editing and you go to connected only, see, it's perfectly smooth. And this is kind of the base algorithm that now is going to power expand and the new tools that come with it. Okay, so now that we have the introduction and what's the point of creating mask like this, I'm going to show you like step by step the new feature and everything that you can do with it. It's like, this is going to start like the basics and how it was designed, and I'm going to end like in those crazy demos when you say like, how is this even possible? Okay. So the first thing you need to know is like, expand is the basic tool for creating kind of selections and patterns. It's the equivalent in edit mode to like selecting loops. It's like the tool does nothing by itself, but it's a tool that creates data for the rest of scale mode to interact with. In that case, the first thing you are going to notice with expand is like the previous shift A operator that was used in the old expand version. The new one is now going to create a perfect circle, which makes much sense. And of course, if you enable symmetry, it's going to be symmetrical. And the same if with Shift W, it's going to create the same but with a facet. Those are the main shortcuts you need to know for using expand, which as you can see are located in the left part of the keyboard, so they are more accessible. Which, by the way, the A shortcut is the pie menu for masking options and the W is the pie menu for facet options. So kind of makes sense, Shift A and Shift W for expand. Okay, first thing you need to know is like, when you're using expand for mask, it creates an inverted mask by default. It's like, this is actually the mask that the expand is creating. This is for a reason, and because I noticed that when I'm actually sculpting and I've used the mask brush, what I and what most people usually do is like, they paint a mask because this is the area they want to work on, and then invert the mask. By the way, don't use the old shortcut for Alt M, I think it is, to invert the masks. Like, if you press I, you can, with the A key, you have the mask by menu and you can invert super fast and clear the mask. So yeah, it's like, the kind of the concept of the mask is intended to work in the opposite ways. Like, you don't mask the areas you don't want to work on, but you mask the area where you want to focus on, and then you invert. That's why expand starts inverted by default. As you notice, if you start another mask, it's going to remove and delete the previous mask. So can you create like more complex shapes with this new expand? Like, yeah, you can. What you need to know is like, when you press expand, now expand is a modal operator. So there are a lot of shortcuts you can press now to tweak the behavior of the tool. So the first shortcut I'm going to explain is the F key, which flips the area of expand. So now you can expand the mask like this and have this area mask. Okay, so now I'm going to create, let's say I want another circle here. So if I start expand again and I press F, the whole circle is gone. But for this, there's another feature of expand, which is called preserve, which is the E key. When you press the E key, it's going to add the new mask to the previous one. And with this, you can start creating masks through the surface of the object, as complex as you want to, which is basically Shift A, and you can press E and F at the same time, which are also located in the first. It's like it's the natural position of the hand, and you can start creating a lot of masks and creating like new shapes. And if this is the area you want to work on, you can invert it and you have your area. Which, by the way, I'm going to give you another tip. If you want to focus only on an area of your sculpt, you can start expand in that area and have this area unmasked. Sculpt mode will like kind of disable the rest of the mesh that is fully masked. So for tools like the filters or Elastic Deform, you can quite get some kind of performance improvement out of having as much mask area as possible. Okay, now I'm going to show you the next feature. Remember the patch I showed you like before by Brecht about the geodesic distances. I'm going to explain you what the geodesic distances are. Which is... nope. This one. Okay. Let's say we have this mesh, which are just 3 quads, and we want to calculate the distance from this vertex to this one. It's like the regular distance you are used to is like the shortest path between the two, like through space. But the way expand works is not actually going to expand the mask this way. It's going to calculate the distance like this, going through the surface, searching the shortest path, like walking through the polygons and crossing through the edges. What implication does this have? Imagine if you have this case and you want to go from here to here, and there's a hole in the middle of the topology. With the previous expand, and with a brush follow for any other tool, it's going to calculate the distance like this. But expand can actually find the path through the hole and expand the mass following this direction. In fact, I'm going to prove you that this is true. So look how the mask propagates, and here it's going to turn into the other direction and it's going to find the other vertex. Okay, so what's the deal with this? Okay, I'm going to show you. That mode is the default mode that Spant is going to use to create the mask, which is called geodesics, which is this default that creates a circle. But expand includes like 8 other options to create different shapes with the mask or with the facet. Out of those 8 options, there are 4 that are directly accessible in the model keymap, and the other 4 are more for internal use. So with the number keys, you can switch live the shape of the mask from 1, which is the default, 2, which is called topology, 3, that is called topology diagonals, and 4, that is called spherical. That looks the same, but it's not the same. I'm going to show you why it's not the same. If you create a facet and hide it, if you start expanding here, you see that the mask expands following the shape of the hole.